Good God, ain't it funky now? You know, the mystery man came over and he said, I'm out of sight. He said, for a nominal service charge, I could reach Nirvana tonight. If I was ready, willing, and able to pay him his regular fee, he would drop all the rest of his pressing affairs and devote his attention to me. But I said,
look here, brother, who you jiving with that cosmic debris?
Who you jiving with that cosmic debris?
Look here, brother,
don't you waste your time on me. Well, the mystery man got nervous and he fidgeted around a bit. He reached in the pocket of his mystery robe and he whipped out a shaving kit. Now I thought it was a razor and a can of foaming goo. But he told me right then, when the top popped open, there was nothing his box won't do. With the oil of Aphrodite and the dust of the Grand Wazoo, he said, you might not believe this, little fella, but it'll cure your asthma too. And I said, oh really?
Look here, brother.
Look here, brother.
Who you jiving with that cosmic guru?
Now what kind of a guru are you anyway?
Look here, brother.
Peek-a-boo. Don't you waste your time on me. Napoleon. Thank you. got troubles of my own, I said, and you can't help me out. Well, take your meditations and your preparations and ram it up your snout. But I've got a crystal ball, he said, and he held it on up to the light. So I snatched it all away from him, and I showed him how to do it right. I wrapped a newspaper around my head so I'd look like I was deep. I said some mumbo jumbos then, and I told him he was going to sleep. I wrapped his rings and pocket watch and everything else I found. I had that sucker hypnotized. He couldn't even make a sound. I proceeded to tell him his future then, as long as he was hanging around. I said, the price of meat has just gone up, and your old lady has just went down. Look here, brother.
Who you jiving with that cosmic debris?
Now, is that a real poncho or is that a Sears poncho? Don't you know you can make more money as a butcher? So don't you waste your time on me.
The mystery man came over and he said, I'm out of sight. He said, for a nominal service charge, I could reach Nirvana tonight. I was ready, willing, and able to pay him his regular fee. He would drop all the best of his pressing affairs and devote his attention to me. But I said,
look here, brother, who you jiving with that cosmic debris?
Now who you jiving with that cosmic? Troubles of my own, I said, and you can't help me out. So take your meditations and your preparations and ram it up your snout.
But I got that crystal ball,
he said, and held it to the light. So I snatched it all away from him, and I showed him how to do it right.
I wrapped the newspaper around my head so I looked like I was dead. I said some mumble jumbo then, I told him he was going to sleep. I robbed his rings and rocket watch and everything else about. I had that sucker hypnotized, he couldn't even make a sound. I proceeded to tell him his future then, as long as he was hanging.
Price of meat has just gone up and your old lady has just gone down.
Look here, brother. Who you jiving with that cosmic debris?
Now is that a real poncho or is that a Sears poncho? Don't you know you can make more money as a butcher? So don't you waste your time on me.
Don't waste it.
He said, for a nominal service charge, I could reach Nirvana tonight. If I was ready, willing, and able to pay him his regular fee, he would drop all the rest of his pressing affairs and devote his attention to me. But I said,
oh dear brother, who you jiving with that cosmic debris?
Jiving with that cosmic debris.
Okay, brother.
Don't you waste your time on me. Well, the mystery man got nervous and he fidgeted around a bit. He reached in the pocket of his mystery robe and he whipped out a shaving kit. Now I thought it was a razor and a can of foaming goo, but he told me right then when the top popped open there was nothing his box won't do. With the oil of Aphrodite and the dust of the Grand Wazoo, he said, you might not believe this, little fella, but it'll cure your asthma too. And I said,
okay, brother, who you jiving with that cosmic debris?
Now what kind of a guru are you anyway?
Look here, brother,
don't you waste your time on me. We'll be right back. troubles of my own, I said, and you can't help me out, so take your meditations and your preparations and ram it up your snout. But I've got a crystal ball, he said, and he held it to the light. So I snatched it all away from him, and I showed him how to do it right. I wrapped the newspaper around my head so I looked like I was deep. I said some mumbo jumbles then, and I told him he was going to sleep. I robbed his rings and pocket watch and everything else I found. I had that sucker hypnotized. He couldn't even make a sound. I proceeded to tell him his future then, as long as he was hanging around. I said, the price of meat has just gone up and your old lady has just gone down. Well, yeah, brother. Who you jiving with that cosmic debris? Now who you jiving? Don't you know you can make more money as a butcher? So don't you waste none of your time on me.
The mystery man came over and he said, I'm out of sight. He said, for a nominal service charge, I could reach Nirvana tonight if I was ready, willing, and able to pay him his regular fee. He would drop all the rest of his pressing affairs and devote his attention to me. But I said,
look here, Father, who you driving with that cosmic debris?
Now, who are you driving with that cosmic debris?
Uh-huh. Look here, Father, don't you waste your time on me.
The mystery man got nervous and he fidgeted around a bit. He reached in the pocket of his mystery robe and he whipped out a shaving kit. Now I thought it was a razor and a can of foaming good, but he told me right then when the top popped open there was nothing his box won't do with the oil of Aphrodite and the dust of the Grand Wazoo. He said, you might not believe this little fella, but it'll cure your asthma too. And I said, hey,
look here, Father, who you jiving with the cosmic debris?
Now what kind of a guru are you anyway?
Look here, Father, don't you waste your time on me.
Troubles of my own, I said, and you can't help me out. So take your meditations and your preparations and ram it up your snout.
I got the crystal ball,
he said, and held it on up to the light. So I snatched it all away from him, and I showed him how to do it right.
I wrapped the newspaper around my head so it looked like I was deep. I said some mumbo jumbles then,
I told him he was going to sleep. Around his rings and his pocket watch and everything else I found, I had that sucker hypnotized. He couldn't even make a sound. I proceeded to tell him his future then, as long as he was hanging around. I said,
the price of meat has just gone up,
and your lady has just gone down. Look here, brother, who you jiving with that cosmic degree?
Now, is that a real poncho or is that a New Jersey poncho? Don't you know, you could make more money in the Navy. So don't you waste your time on me. Ray White, Chad Wackerman, Scott Tunis, Alan Zavod, Bobby Martin, Ike Willis, Igo.
This is a personal thing. I think that if you wanted to make top 10 hits and sell millions of records, you could. And
yeah,
you choose
but who
not
wants to
to
go through life with a tiny nose and one glove on?
Yes, we must be economical about the tape. The mystery man came over, and he said, I'm out of sight. He said, for a nominal service charge, I could reach Nirvana tonight. If I was ready, willing, and able to pay him his regular fee, why, he would drop all the rest of his pressing affairs and devote his attention to me. But I said,
look here, brother, who you jiving with that cosmic degree?
Who you jiving with a cosmic degree? Don't you waste your time on me. The mystery man got nervous, and he fidgeted around a bit. He reached in the pocket of his mystery robe, and he whipped out a shaving kit. Now I thought it was a razor and a can of foaming goo. But they told me right then, when the top popped open, there was nothing his box won't do. But the oil of Aphrodite and the dust of the Grand Wazoo. He said, you might not believe this, Mort, but it'll cure your crab cakes too. And I said, hey,
look here, buddy.
Morty,
who you jiving with that cosmic debris?
Yes, indeed, who are you jiving with that cosmic debris? Don't you waste your time on me. Go, man, go! Yeah.
I've got troubles of my own, I said, and you can't help me out. So take your meditations and your preparations and ram it up your... But I've got a crystal ball, he said, and he held it on up to the light. So I snatched it all away from him, and I showed him how to do it right. Yes, let's boogie. I ran the newspaper around my head, so I looked like I was deep. I said some mumbo jumbos then, and I told him he was going to sleep. I robbed his rings and pocket watch, and everything else I found, yeah. I had that sucker hypnotized, he couldn't even make a sound. I proceeded to tell him his future then, as long as he was hanging around, I said, the price of meat has just gone, and your old lady has just gone.
Look here, brother.
Okay, brother.
Who you jiving with that cosmic debris?
Now, is that a real poncho, or is that a Sears poncho? Or is it Bob Duffy's pants? Don't you know, you can make more money as a butcher? So don't you waste your waste on me.